only impacting fruits and vegetables, but it may be causing more spiders to come out and into our homes. KMBC 9's David Hall spoke to a pest control company, and he joins us live tonight. David?
Yes, good evening, Kelly. The exterminators tell me that if you have bushes like these, you're supposed to trim them and keep them neatly and nicely trimmed, because that will help you cut down on your spiders around your house.
We followed Zip Zap's Jeffrey Priest and his son to George Sadley's Briarcliff Village house. They were treating it for too many spiders.
We're so busy right now, we can't hardly keep up because of the fact that we didn't have a winter. We had a very mild winter, and it was very warm. It's been very warm and extremely hot now, and a lot of these spiders are coming inside. They're finding places outside. They're searching for food. They're moving around trying to find other insects.
Which is not good news for Shadley and his wife.
The ones we've been seeing are kind of large and hairy, and I just don't want them in the house.
Priest power sprayed a chemical on and around the house to kill the spiders and create a barrier for future ones. He offered Shadley some tips.
I understand floodlights are for security reasons and all that, but the more you keep those lights on, the more the spiders are going to be around the house and stuff like that. But a lot of this leaf litter right here, we could probably, get that cleaned up.
I just feel sorry for the little guy because he's so small.
Over in Olathe, we ran into Randy Chavez. Look what a brown recluse spider did to her dog.
Considering how it took down my 8-pound chihuahua, I can imagine what it would do for a human.
Another tip is to eliminate the clutter in and around your house because spiders like the clutter. Reporting live, I'm David Hall, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
David, thank you. Now, Priest says some of the spiders you need to watch out for in this area include the brown recluse, the black widow, and wolf spiders.